Welcome back. Now, let's continue the topic on ancient civilizations. In the previous classes, we have time traveled to Sumerian civilization and also Indus Valley civilization. Now, let's look at the Egyptian civilization. Okay? Now, let's see when was this civilization dwelled. This civilization was dwelled about around 3100 BCE. Right? Now, where is it situated? Where is this civilization situated? For that, let's come to this map. So, as you know, Egypt is situated here, but just little extension. So, this whole is the Egyptian civilization. So, before this civilization, how was this map? Actually, here, this was divided into two. As we know, this is Nile River, and here, when this Nile River joins and in the Mediterranean Sea, here we find the lower course of the Nile River, so that the land will be sloped. So this is the lower course, right? So this part was known as Lower Egypt. This part was known as Lower Egypt, and this part was known as Upper Egypt. Right? Before this civilization, this part was known as Lower Egypt and this part was known as Upper Egypt. Now, a person called Narmer. Now, who is this Narmer? He is the first pharaoh of the Egyptian civilization. Right? First pharaoh. Right? Now, who are pharaohs? Pharaohs are nothing but kings of Egyptian civilization. Right? Kings of Egypt are known as, emperors of Egypt are known as pharaohs. Now, the first pharaoh of Egyptian civilization was Narmer. This Narmer, this person, he unified these two parts, the Lower Egypt and the Upper Egypt. He unified these two parts, which was known as political unification. So, thus, these two parts combined and this total formed a civilization, which is now known as the Egyptian civilization, right? Yeah, in the year of 3100 BC. This is not exact, but around 3100 BC. Right? So, this was formed by the unification of Lower Egypt and the Upper Egypt. By whom? First pharaoh called Narmer. Okay? Now, let's look at, you know, actually this is a deserted area, right? Egypt, so this whole will be Sahara desert, right? This is a deserted area. So, actually, making a civilization in this area is a bit difficult. So, how did they get succeeded? They used success tips. What are the success secrets of the civilization? We'll see that. For that, the people in this Egyptian civilization, they mainly had three abilities. Due to these three abilities, they were able to, you know, develop the Egyptian civilization, right? So now, what are these three abilities? These three abilities are 1, 2 and 3, right? So one was, they were able to adapt the conditions of which river? Nile River. They were able to adapt the conditions of Nile River, and also they were able to predict flooding. They were able to predict flooding. In future, when will the flooding occur, they were able to predict that, right? Yeah, okay. And also, they were able to control the irrigation. They were able to control the irrigation. They were able to control the irrigation of the fertile valley of Nile. Of this Nile River, they were able to control the irrigation. That means agriculture. Right? Due to these three abilities of the people, they were able to, this civilization succeeded. Right? Now, as I said, farming and agriculture. Now, let's look at their farming. What crops did they cultivate? So, coming to farming. So, actually, we know that this is a deserted area, right? Now, let's write here. This is a dry area, dry desert. And very little rains. Very little rains occur here. So, it's also difficult for farming. But these people managed to farm. So, this situation is not at all favorable for farming.
But how did they succeed in farming? And also they managed to flourish by utilizing the water of river Nile, right? They also, you know, they cultivated almost every crop like barley, and they cultivated mainly three crops. Mainly how many? Three. What are they? One is wheat, one is flax, one is papyrus. Wheat is later grounded into flour. Wheat was later grounded into flour. Flax, it was made into, it was spun into linen. And papyrus, it was a paper substitute. They used it as a paper. Right? Actually, the word, the English word paper came from papyrus. Papyrus, paper, right? So these are their farming facilities. What did they farm and how did they manage to farm? They managed to flourish the farming by the use of the water of River Nile. Okay? So this is about the introduction and farming.
Now let's look at their trades. With whom did they trade? What did they trade? Now let's look at that. So now let's first look at their imports. What were their imports and from where? So first they imported from Nubia. What did they import? Incense and gold. Now actually where is Nubia? Nubia is here. Okay, this is Nubia. And with Afghanistan, they imported lapis lazuli. Now what is lapis lazuli? It is a blue stone. Right? Lapis lazuli is a blue stone imported from Afghanistan. Now where is Afghanistan? Right here. This is Afghanistan. Right. Now with Greece, they imported olive oil, and also with Crete, the same. Olive oil. Okay. So, Greece is, as you know, it is located in the Balkan Peninsula, right here. So this is Greece, and this is Crete. Right. So these were their imports. Now let's see their exporting. So actually the imports which goods they imported, that most of them were raw materials, right? Now these goods which they exported were mainly finished goods like glass and stone objects. Right, and also they exported gold and papyrus and what else? Yeah, also grains. Right, so these were their exporting and this was their importing. Now let's look at their houses and their structures. So houses. So first, actually they used to live in huts made of papyrus reed. So the early Egyptians, they used to live in huts made of papyrus reed. Then they lived in buildings made of bricks. Right, and then next they used to live in houses with two floored houses. How? So if this is a building, it had two floors. So in the ground floor they used to store grains. Yeah, store crops. they use it to store crops. And in the first floor, they use it to live. First floor is for living and ground floor is for storing crops. Right? So, this was the house structure. Now, they also constructed reed canopies. Now, why did they construct these reed canopies? For protecting themselves from the sun. Right? And also, the furniture in these houses was made of wood. Wooden furniture was there. And also, the wealthy people had courtyard at the center of their houses. The wealthy people who were there, they had courtyard at the center of their houses. Okay? So, this is about houses and the structure. Right, now let's come to this. Hygiene and personal appearance. The people in this Egyptian civilization bathed in River Nile. In the River of Nile, the people of this civilization bathed. And also the clothing. With what did they bath? With a pasty soap. With what was this soap made of? With animal fat, or we can say chalk. Animal fat and chalk, with the help of this, they created a soap, a pasty soap. So next, the clothing was made of bleached white linen sheets. Right? The dresses were made of bleached white linen sheets. And also the upper class people. The upper class people, they used wigs, jewelry, and also cosmetics. Right? So this is about the hygiene and personal appearance. This is about the houses. Now let's discuss about the mummification and pyramids. Earlier, after the death of pharaohs, they threw their bodies in sand pits. But later, they used coffins to put their bodies in. After that, they used mummification. Now, what is mummification? The method of preserving bodies is known as mummification. Okay? Right. Now, let's look at the procedure of mummification. How did they mummify? So first, they removed all the internal organs. All the internal organs were removed from the body. Then they put the body in natron. Now what is natron? Natron is nothing but mixture of salt. A mixture of salt is known as natron. They put the body in natron and also they tied up the body with linen. Yeah, they wrapped the body with linen. And they also put amulets in it. And they finally, after wrapping and putting the amulets, they put the body in anthropoid coffins. Right? And also, they put in these anthropoid coffins, they also put luxury goods, books, and also statues. Right? Luxury things they put as they were pharaohs. They also believed in afterlife. Right? So, that is why they also constructed preserving the security guard of the body, so that which we call as pyramids. Pyramids are nothing but royal tombs, right? Pyramids are royal tombs. There are many pyramids in the Egypt which were built in the Egyptian civilization, right? And also they also believed that kings, these pharaohs are gods. They also believed that kings are gods and they are immortal. So thus they tried to guard their bodies even after the death. Right? They put these anthropoid coffins in pyramids. They constructed pyramids and put them in it. Actually, the pyramids of Giza, which are situated on the Giza plateau, are very famous. Among them, the highest one is the Great Pyramid of Giza, which was built for King Khufu. Right? Khufu? King Khufu. For him, this Great Pyramid of Giza was built. This Great Pyramid of Giza consisted of more than 2 million blocks. And each block, more than 2 million stone blocks. Each stone blocks weighed 2 to 50 tons. Each stone block's weight is 2 to 50 tons. Like that, more than 2 million blocks they used to construct the Great Pyramid of Giza for King Khufu. Right? So, this is about the pyramids, which are the royal tombs, and this is about the mummification. Now, let's look at the Egyptian gods. So, gods. So, most of these gods have animal-headed. Most of these gods have animal heads, right? So, one of them is Ra god. Who is Ra? Ra is the sun god. Ra is also the lord of all gods, right? As I said, animal head. Ra also has an animal head, that is falcon-headed man. He is a falcon-headed god who has a crown on which there is a sun disk and also a sacred cobra, right? Now, next comes Thoth. Now, who is Thoth? Thoth is the moon god. He is also the god of wisdom and knowledge. He is ibis-headed man, right? Thoth is moon god and also ibis-headed man. Next comes Bastet. Who is Bastet now? Bastet is the daughter of Ra. Ra is the sun god, right? His daughter is Bastet. She is cat-headed woman, right? Cat-headed woman, Bastet. Next comes Amun. Who is Amun? Amun is the god of air and also he is the king of all gods. Later, Ra and Amun. Amun plus Ra became Amun-Ra. Right? Amun and Ra became, they were merged and became Amun-Ra. Right? Next comes Horus. Who is Horus? Horus is the light and sky god. And he is also falcon-headed, but he does not have any sun disk or sacred cobra, right? Next comes Jeb. Who is Jeb? Jeb is the earth god. Then Tefnut is rain goddess. Next comes Nut. Tefnut, here Nut, okay? So, Nut is the sky goddess. Now, Jeb and Nut are wife and husband, right? Next comes Sekhmet. Sekhmet is the war goddess, goddess of war. She has lion head, right? Sekhmet is the lion-headed goddess, which she is a goddess of war, right? So this is about the gods and goddesses of the Egyptian civilization. Now let's look at the kings and queens of the Egyptian civilization, right? So the first one comes Narmer. As we have discussed, he is the first pharaoh. Yeah, what are pharaohs? Pharaohs are nothing but kings of the Egyptian civilization, right? So, next comes Ramses II, second Ramses. He is the most powerful pharaoh in the Egyptian civilization, right? And his successors called him as the great ancestor. He is the most powerful pharaoh, right? Ramses II, second Ramses. Then next comes first Thutmose. Yeah, he ruled 66 years, Ramses II. Second Ramses ruled 66 years. Then next comes first Thutmose. Then third one, yeah, the fourth one is third Amenhotep. Then, yeah, I forgot to mention, women in this civilization were given, unlike the other civilizations, here women were given the same rights, right? Women were given the equal rights as the rights given to men, right? So, this is an advanced civilization. So, the first queen, the first great woman in recorded history, the first great woman in recorded history is Hatshepsut. right? She is the first great woman in recorded history. Next comes Nefertiti. Actually, during her ruling period, Nefertiti and Akhenaten. Nefertiti's wife, Akhenaten's husband. They both ruled together that kingdom. And next one comes 7th Cleopatra. She is the last ruler of independent ancient Egypt. Right? She was the last ruler of the independent ancient Egypt. After her death, who was she? 7th Cleopatra. After her death, when did she die? In the year 30 BCE. Right? After 30 BCE, this Egyptian civilization, this Egypt area, went under the Roman Empire. Right? She was the last ruler of the Egyptian civilization. So this is about the pharaohs and queens. So this is finally about the Egyptian civilization. I'll meet you in the next class with another civilization. Thank you.